Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today, we're diving into the world of sci-fi action with a movie that's all about vampires, viruses, and virtual reality. In the mid-21st century, the hemagglyphagic virus HGV, an obscure virus from Eastern Europe which was being used to breed stronger and faster soldiers, escaped the laboratory. Once infected, people have a lifespan of about 12 years. But first they are reduced to hemophages, aka vampires. They take on many characteristics including extended eye teeth, regeneration, accelerated reflexes, and increased strength. One of the victims is Violet Song Jack Sheriff. Because she was infected while pregnant, Violet was secured to a holding camp to be studied. Most of the other hemophages have been wiped out, thanks to the actions of Vice Cardinal Ferdinand Daxus, who's determined to wipe out every last hemophage. But the hemophages aren't going to be led like sheep to their slaughter. Hemophages have united, and their resistance and terrorist attacks have become known as the Blood War. It is 12 years later. The scientists terminated Violet's pregnancy, and she has managed to escape the camp and join the hemophage underground. After infiltrating the Arch-Ministry by posing as Courier XPD-154, Violet finds herself in possession of a case that contains the ultimate weapon against hemophages, one that will wipe out the entire hemophagic population. When ordered by her hemophagic superior, Nerva, to destroy the case without opening it, which will set off a bomb that will destroy everything a block around, Violet refuses to comply and opens the case to discover it contains a child. It is both a weapon and a child. She is told, the child contains antigens that will wipe out all existing hemophages. What is Violet to do? Destroy the weapon or protect the child? The child is a 10-year human named Six. Because he is a clone of Eight, he has been raised all his life in a laboratory and knows very little about life outside. Violet takes Six to be examined by her hemophagic friend Garth, who learns that Six has only 8 hours to live and that he's outfitted with a tracking device. So Violet must keep moving lest Daxus catches up with her. Unfortunately, Nerva has made a deal with Daxus and learned that Six doesn't contain an antigen against hemophagia, but against the entire human race. So Nerva seizes Six with the idea of using him against the humans. Violet sets Six free again. In the time they have left before Six dies, Violet takes him to the park. When the time comes, Violet is at his side, but Daxus and his henchmen show up to claim the body and kill Violet. Fortunately for Violet, Garth manages to retrieve her body before Daxus's incendiary team can destroy it. After several hours of surgery, Garth is able to bring Violet back to life. Violet goes into a deep depression but recovers when she senses that Six is not dead and that he needs her help to get away from Daxus. Violet storms the Arch-Ministry just as Daxus is about to saw into Six's brain. Violet single-handedly wipes out everyone in the Arch-Ministry except for Daxus. As they face each other, Daxus tells Violet the truth about himself. He's actually a hemophage too. Violet defeats him with a flame pistol and her sword. Violet carries Six to the roof and reawakens him. Six is surprised to still be alive. A flashback reveals one of Violet's terrors at the park protected him from dying by giving him immunity to what was killing him. He tells Violet that there is a cure for hemophagia.
There's a cure.
Overall, Ultraviolet is an action-packed sci-fi thriller that explores some thought-provoking themes. While it may not be a perfect movie, it's definitely worth watching for fans of the genre. What did you think of Ultraviolet? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more movie synopsis, analysis, and reviews. If you like this video, be sure to like, comment, and share it with your friends. Until next time, stay cinematic.